What is up, the world? It is your friendly neighborhood Slipgator here, hanging out today, doing stuff and things on the ARK Survival Evolved Pooping Evolved server. I hope that you guys are having a good day. I'm having a really good day. Really excited about stuff and things, man. I got so many plans for today. I got on today. And I was like, what am I going to do? I can't even decide. There's so many things that I need to get done. But I figured what we're going to do. I know it's going to be a good day. And I hope you guys are having a good day. Like I was saying, I wanted to say, as I always do, thank you guys so much for all your support on the recent ARK videos. It really means a lot to me, and I really, really appreciate it. If you guys like this video, please don't forget to smash the likes button. And don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. I got to do this. I got to tell you guys, we got Blue Dolph now. Blue Dolph. Look how creepy he looks with his white paint job and his blue eyes and his blue nose. It's hot today, by the way. It's a hot one. So Blue Dolph, I got him up to 1,500 HPs. We got a couple hundred melee damage. Not really, you know, doing stuff and things, having a good time with it. And one of the things that I did, when the updates were happening and all that stuff was going on, I did like a half an episode. And it didn't really work. Like, I couldn't really put it in for you guys because it would have been confusing. It was like a half an episode, then the update happened, and then we started doing all that stuff. But in that half of an episode, I wanted to make sure you guys knew, I ended up taming this guy, the double. He was 100 and, I think, 12 level Pteranodon. And we've got his stats up to now 1,600 health. He's got 1,000 stamina, 500 damage. And I didn't pump this at all. He came with 500% melee damage. And I've got his movement speed up to 204.8%. Let's show him how fast you are, man. He's a super fast guy. Super speeded dude. So he's amazing. He's really, really good. We might end up taking and giving Terry away to somebody as a gift or something like that. Where are you, Terry? Where you at, man? Might give Terry away as a gift. But, some of the other guys have been leveling up. I'll show you guys some of that stuff in the future. But one of the things is here on Poop City, let's get on the double. We have a lot of plans for Poop City. Me and my brother are talking about getting a better community area built up here and kind of destroying the wall that's in here. We don't really need it anymore. I mean, this building is pretty weak, guys. This isn't Poop. This is not Poping Evolve level stuff and things. So we're going to do some of that stuff in the future. But a lot of the guys have been talking about this, and we really wanted to make this Poop City thing a thing. Like, we wanted to kind of do this, and we're still going to definitely do it. But the dinosaur issue, like, everybody kind of wants to have a lot of dinosaurs, right? And it just gets to the point, what is this on the side of here? Does it say poop? It just says poop. So, yeah, one of the things is everybody kind of wants a lot of dinosaurs, and it's getting really crowded here. So we just got to realize that we're not going to be able to all have tons and tons of dinos in the area. So that means that we need to have different bases. Now, we already started building our forward operational base, our new kind of stuff and things, our new spot over into this early direction. It's going to be over near where Zul'jin's building. It's not any of the new biomes, but I think it's a really cool spot. And the reason why I decided not to do any of the new biome stuff, it's because we can still build over there. We can still do cool stuff and things. But I just have this idea in my mind about what I want to do with this base. And I just think that this location is going to be so amazing. That's why I want to do it that over in this area. So we're going to head over here today. I also wanted to tell you guys that I've been doing some different things you might see with the graphics. I've changed a few things. And I'll show you here. You can see I'm running now on... Wait, what? I should be running on, there we go, on Lightshafts 1. So it's R.Lightshafts 1 and R.Bloom Quality 0.5. I want a little bit of that ambiance because it really makes things unbelievably cool looking. And especially with the fireflies at night and stuff like that, like, I feel like I'm missing out on the game a little bit. I also decided in my options to turn my sky quality and ground clutter all the way up. And that's just made stuff look like really, really cool. Like, it's hard to really explain it unless you see the difference. But once we get closer down to the ground here, I think you'll see just kind of some of this grass and stuff like that normally wouldn't be there. And over at the new base, it makes a huge difference. Like, it really looks cool. You can see stuff and things just look really amazing. So, that's a couple of changes I did. If you notice, the graphics are different. Everything that you do in the game is going to make a performance difference for you. So we lost a little bit of frames in there. And if you're wondering, you can actually type stat FPS and you'll see in the upper right-hand corner there, I'm actually only rocking about 30 frames. If I turn all that stuff up or down, pardon me, I might get up to like 35, maybe 40. So I don't know. You know, it's kind of a trade-off. It's kind of a trade-off. I run a NVIDIA TI, 780 Ti, pardon me. I couldn't remember there for a second. What level are you, homie? Level 68, that's not even a mouse on a wheel. Maybe a very small mouse on a wheel, but it's not really a good mouse on a wheel. You're dead. So anyway, that's kind of what's going on with the graphics. If you notice, there was a difference. Today, what I want to do is at the forward operational base, we got to get some more dinos over there. And really, in order to make it safe, we got to get a wall built. The plan is, whoa, I'm inside of him. I'm inside of this. What happened? Oh, baby, that was a close one. Holy crap, gameplay, you let me down, man. You let me down a little bit, and we almost totally got destroyed. How's our stats? Our armor's doing okay. Anything else bad around in the area? All right. Gameplay. Dude, you got to help me, man. You're my buddy. You're my best buddy. Don't leave me like that. Don't leave me hanging. So we got to go to the new base. We got to build a wall. That's what we're going to be doing. I will BRBs, peeps. And we're back. All right. Here we are at the new spot. And I've been taking a look around and kind of trying to get an understanding of what we want to do here. Now, the wall, what I really have planned here is for, I want to do building in this season with metal. It's going to be really, really tough. There's going to be a lot of resource gathering involved, a lot of off-camera work stuff and things are going to happen. Right here, we have a pretty good amount, like straight away. So we're going to need a few RGs and maybe this one or two. It's really not that far, so honestly, you could probably just use one RG that has a really high weight to come over here, get metal, and just fly it back over here, drop it into some refining forges and go back and stuff like that. So we may not need like a fleet of RGs or anything like that, but the idea that I want to do in this area is I'm really looking to do kind of an open floor plan, so stuffing things really, really open, kind of a lot of pillars, not a lot of walls. So we got to make sure that this area is kind of walled in. I think that I'm going to drop a wall in right here, all the way along this, over to this area right here. Probably then back over here, get something going back like in a visually direction, then take a right, head back here like a so, get this all walled in as well. And then over here on this side, it's a little bit tricky. It's a little bit hard to know exactly what we're going to do. We're going to have to take a right. Maybe we'll take a right right here and just try to link it up to this and have that be the other edge of our stuff and things. So, again, I was saying I want to build out of metal, but obviously in the beginnings is here, we're just not going to be able to do that. There's just not going to be a way to do it at all. So I thought today we'd just start getting stuff and things done, getting some resources gathered up, and get part of the wall done at the very least. We can get probably a 3-high done all the way around everything, I think. It's going to be a lot, guys. And then we got to get at least one behemoth gate in there so that we can get in and out with our stuff and things. I brought Hungry over. I painted him up. Look how amazing he looks. Pretty cool. You know, with these wolves, though, one of the things that's interesting is you can see back here, you actually can't paint their fur. Like, their fur is like a separate, I don't know, like a separate entity or something like that. But you can paint, you can see in his tail here, he does have some blue in there. Isn't that weird? It's weird and pretty cool. And I pumped his stats up a little bit. Oh, he's hurt. Weird. He was either in stasis or something happened. So we do have a defender. And one of the other things just to let you know about these wolves that I've been finding out is I think that their base damage is really, really high. Because he is, I mean, he's pretty high. He's a 113, but he's not like a 170 or 180 or anything like that. And I had him out here the other day. I wish I could find some. All right, here we go. Let's check this out. Let me turn my guy back on. So this is just a level 4. So he's pretty low, but he's a turtle, right? So they normally take a few hits. 2, 3, 4, 5. Like, that was fast for a turtle, man. I don't even care if it is level 4. Like, that was a really quick kill. So I'm thinking maybe these guys have a really, really high base damage. Because, you know, in an arc, we don't see stats. We just see percentages of a base. And it might be something that you can see on the wiki. I'll probably take a look at that while I'm doing some harvesting here today. Oh, wait, no, that's a cat noise. What kind of noise does a wolf make when it jumps? Hold on, let me test out a couple noises here. Wolf. Yeah, that's the noise it makes. Wolf. All right, that was really a bad noise. All right, so we're going to pop into here. I'm going to go ahead and start doing some resource gathering, and I will be our bees, peeps. And we're back, and I was doing stuff and things. I'm feeling a little bit excited, and I thought I'd tell you guys about what's going on. Inside of this chest, I've built 68 wooden fence foundations and 110 wooden walls. of which we will be using none, because after I had built them all, I decided that this was a bad idea, and really what we should do is just build behemoth stone gates, because they're way easier to build, and they're way bigger, and kind of wanted to do something more aesthetic, but the placement of thousands and thousands of wooden walls just seems silly, considering we can just place a couple of the behemoth gates. And look, they don't even weigh anything. They're absolutely amazing. And so then I started to take a look down here where we're going to place all these. And then William Shatner started following us. All right, so then we're down in this area like so. And what we're going to do is pop like this and go like this and go like this and take a look. So what I'm thinking about doing is aligning these in a line in this early direction and coming over to this early direction like so. So I'm thinking what I'm going to do is come over here and go to my K menu, and then I'll squirt around like so, and I'll see that I kind of can't get a good alignment from this angle. So I'll hit escape a little bit, then K, and then right mouse button. Then I'll move over into this area right here, like so. And I'm wondering if these fence foundations are going to stop us from being able to place these behemoth gates. We shall find out momentarily. So then I'll place... All right, here we go. Let's get into our K menu like this. We'll back off like so. Maybe turn a little bit and then take a look back and see what we can see. I like that quite a bit. I want to go as far over to the side as I can. Oh, we can go really far over to the side, can't we? Oh, that's good right there like that. Nailed it, Ace, it can't be stopped. Now we will take another behemoth gate. We'll move it over to this lead direction. Try to get this aligned as nicely as we possibly can. Let me just take a look over there. Yeah, this looks good. I'm hoping that this will work out great. Like so. We will take another one. We will move over here like so. And it looks like this one's going to be off the ground a little bit, and I may not be able to place a fourth. So I'm going to maybe just go like this. And then we'll do one more and see if we just move into this early direction, is that going to work out for us? Oh, whoa, it's snapping to that foundation. Oh, man, and we were all aligned up and everything was perfect. And now it's snapping to that foundation. All right, so we'll have to go pop out of here like so. We'll just go ahead and demolish this bad boy. Go back into here. We'll get our behemoth gate out. We'll K like so. All right, let's turn. Move up. Oh, wait, what's it aligning to? Oh, wait, is there something else in this area that I can't see because of ground clutter? Right here, there's one. Wooden fence foundation. Is that the only wooden fence foundation here that I got left? All right, let's take a look here again one more time. All right, there we go. That solves our problem. And then we are going to have a little bit of a thing there. I'm not sure how we're going to fix that. This will be better. All right, so let's go like this. And then can we just do another one? Like, is it even possible? No. So we're going to have a little bit of a gap right here in which we'll have to just kind of use our fence foundations and our regular walls in order to fill, I think. It's going to be a little bit wacky, but this is way better. And we've basically already almost finished the entire fence. So now we can go into our inventories, take our doorways like so, and go ahead and squirt these inside. Nailed it. Aced it. Can't be stopped. And so we, you know, this is the way that arc is. I mean, wait, no, that's for repair. No, demolish. Nailed it. That didn't break anything, did it? No. So there is these little gaps and stuff and things like that, but it just can't be helped in the way the game is right now. And then we do have a little bit of, oh, you want to go? You want to bring it to the hoop? Yeah, you're lucky. You're lucky this time. All right, so over here, I think we are going to have to use some fence foundations and go ahead and build a little bit of a wall. It's super big gap there. And there really isn't much we can do about that. So, but we've got a big part of the wall done already. Now, this does take a lot of materials. Every single behemoth gate does take a lot of stuff and things. You're talking about 300 stone, 180 wood, 120 thatch, 250 stone, 150 wood. Okay. 550 stone, 330 wood, 220 thatch for each one of these wall sections. So, yeah, but it's going to be great. It's going to be big. And, oh, also, the other thing I want to show you guys is that we have one of the settings for the server turned way down where When you place an object or there's a dino or anything in the area, there's a distance between it and where stuff starts to, like, respawn. Like, any of the flora, fauna, dinos and stuff and things like that. And so we had that turned way down. And over here, you can see I've placed all these foundations to stop stuff from spawning in the area. And we're getting all these little pockets of stuff spawning back in, which isn't really going to work out for us. So what I decided to do is I got in touch with Drax. He does a lot of our server administration stuff and things, and we're going to change that setting. We're going to turn that down a little bit. But what I'm thinking about now is basically getting the stuff and things together to build, I don't know, I'm thinking 40 more behemoth gates. It's going to be a lot. It's going to be a lot of gathering of the stuff and things. So we've got, what, 3 more right here, so that means we need 37 to meet our goal, which is a heck of a goal. So we're going to put some stuff and things away here. I'm going to go back into gathering stuff and things mode, and then I will be our beast peeps. And we're back after quite a while. I managed to get 15 of each one of the gates, and I kind of felt like I needed a breather, because we already made 19 gates today. Oh, I got this wall done. Yeah, let me show you the wall thing, too. It was not super easy. I had to do some of it flying. I placed some of these by standing, but when it got to these last two, I actually had to, like, overburden gameplay and then come down here and fly in order to place those. But it came out pretty good. I mean, it's not super flying or anything like that, but if you've built an arc, you know that sort of stuff. You can't really make it flat on top. Kind of difficult to do. So, all right, I wanted to place some of the gates, but then you know what I thought we should do? I was kind of taking a look around here. They got this pretty tree, and I was sitting over here, and the pipes, whatever, don't pay. But just taking a look over here, this beautiful waterfall. It's so amazing. This super crazy trees in the background. But you know, one of the things they added in the last update that we haven't really played around with yet, it's furniture. So we've got this bench right here. It takes 120 wood, which seems a little much. But anyway, 45 fiber, 55 thatch. We got some fiber around here somewhere, I think. Oh, there's 45 of it right there. We got some thatch here somewhere too, I think. Oh, there's 55 there. Do we have 120 wood? We got 120 wood. Let's go ahead and craft up this bench. Let's see what this is all about, babes. It's changing the face of Ark. And we have a bench. It's an amazing thing. Oh, it's like a little bench. It's just like a little bench thing. And you know, this place right here would be a great place. Maybe right under the tree. Maybe like right here for a little bench. Actually, we'll put our bench right here. And we have a little bench. Can you sit on that? No. Hold E for more options. We can just break it. That's all we can do to it. And we can enjoy what it looks like. And it looks really cool. You know, maybe we need a chair. Maybe we need a chair, too. Let's take a look here. Craftables, chair, 30 wood. Only 30 wood? 18 thatch, 14 fiber. Okay, so let's grab our fiber. Let's grab our thatch. Let's grab our thatch, I said. And let's grab some wood. And let's make a chair. And see what the chair's all about! This is pretty cool stuff. I think internally, when you get a house built or something like that, being able to build some of this furniture is going to be really cool. All right, so we got this chair. Maybe we'll place our chair, like, right over here. Like, right by our bench. And then maybe we'll face it. Yeah, maybe just kind of like it. We could face it over here. Maybe if somebody wants to kind of be able to, like, turn their head to the left and look at the people on the bench and then turn their head to the right and look at the waterfall. So now there's a little chair. There's a little bench. A little spot over here. Maybe we'll put a little standing torch up, too, at some point. All right, so anywho, what I want to do next is grab some of these guys here. So let's go ahead and grab 1, 2, 3. No. 1, 2, 3. I said 3? 1, 2, 3. I said 3? Like so. And I think we're actually hungry or something. Oh, it looks like we might have been thirsty. So let's kind of taking a look at how this is all going to look, how this is all going to work. And what I think we're going to do is going to be a little bit crazy. I actually cleared out, like, all of these trees, all of the stuff and things. I was really far back. I wanted to take a little break because I wanted to let some stuff respawn in because it was getting to be where I had to go further and further away for resources. So what I'm thinking about doing here is right back into this early area. Let's grab this guy like so, and let's go like this. Are you out? You're out. All right, let's go into the K. And I'm thinking, I kind of wish Let me see. Excuse me. Let me see here. If I go back like this, can I get a better understanding of like how the right angle would be? I feel like I can. Okay, so now what we can do, we can kind of spin. Let's back up here. Here's how we're going to do this, guys. So we kind of want this to be on a right angle with the existing doors that are right over here. So it's kind of a 90 degree angle type deal. I feel like we got to turn a little bit. No, a little bit more. Oh, is it snapping? No, it's not snapping. All right, let's see here. A little bit like this. All right, that's pretty good. Now what we can do is come over into this really direction and kind of come up over into here. Ooh, it wants the place really kind of high. Is that kind of good on that side? No, we got to go in a little bit more. Like so. I think that's what we're going to go with. Nailed it! Aced it, can't be stopped. All right, I like that. So then we can go ahead and grab another gate. Oh, is it? It's going to be really hard for us to see, isn't it? Oh, man, it is going to be hard for us to see. Oh, crap. Oh, we're going to have to clear this area out just to be able to get the placement right. And then the other thing that kind of stinks is it's tough to place and make sure you're perfectly linear, like that you're, you know what I mean? Everything's going to be symmetrical. It'll be a little bit difficult. Yeah, I guess the only option I have now is to go get William Shatner and clear that out again so I can actually see what's going on. And maybe we'll just have to keep placing more. Yeah, I don't want to place more thatch foundations because I want to be able stuff to respawn so I can get resources. It's going to be a balance. So I guess we'll go ahead and get on William and just clear some stuff and things out. And then I'll place more gates and I'll be BRBs, peeps. And we're back and stuff and things are definitely happening, peeps. And it turns out, this is not something you may know. Let's get together and talk really quickly. That when you're building a humongous wall out of behemoth gates and you say to yourself, self, I need to build 40 behemoth gates. You actually only need to build about 14. So just keep that in mind anytime you're building a giant behemoth gate wall and you say to yourself, self, I need to build 40 behemoth gates. It's just not true. It's okay, you know, trust in yourself, but not all the time. Overestimation was the thing. And I feel like it was really good because what happened is our overestimation was peppered with like this reality that was we don't need that many behemoth gates. And are we like, is that good right here? What if we go like more like this? That's maybe a little bit better if we go more like this. That's maybe even a little bit better. Let's go like one of these right here. And then are we able to place? Are you going to like snap? Are you going to be a good little? No, you're not going to be a good little guy, are you? So we can't really tell. Actually, here, check this out. Here's what we'll do. We're just trying to build a wall over here to kind of get it plugged up, so to speak. Let us grab some of our walls that we've brought so thoughtfully. And we'll go like one of these, and we'll go like one of these, and then we'll go like one of those, and then we'll do that. And then now we can actually just see where the next wall would be, and we'll just line it up like a so. And then we'll take another one of our walls here, and we'll go like E, and we'll go like that. And then we'll take another one of our foundations. And because we can't really... What? Why? Oh, no. I thought those dinosaurs coming over to be terrible to us. We will go like that. That looks good. I like that. We'll go like this. Go like this. Nailed the ace that can't be stopped. All right. So now we can grab the rest of our walls. We just need this to be three high. We'll probably end up building it bigger than three high. But let's take a look here and see. We should be able to just go ahead and plug this hole up. In the future, we could actually maybe build a building here. Like a tower or something like that. Oh, whoops! To block it off. And that would be amazing. Get up there, yo. Oh, yeah. Nailed the days that can't be stopped. So now... Oh, we're building a foundation accidentally. So now we have our wall, and it is... completely enclosed. Let me give you a small tour of the area. This is the one side over here, you can see. Then over here, there's a side. Then if you go in a visually direction for a short while, not a long while, you will see there is more of a wall there. Then there's a little piece of a mountain, and then there's some walls here. But this, I think, is a huge, like, it's definitely a good size. And the only real thing we have to worry about getting in here is Flyers. Like, that's it. And the main base is going to be built on this outcropping here, the other outcropping over here, and then on top of there, on top of the top of Tippity Top Top Place. So yeah, babes, we did it. We got all of our guys here, and you know what that means? It means that it's time to move some dinos over. Now, we haven't done this in a long time, but I think we're going to do something pretty cool. I'm going to go ahead and get on gameplay. Let me get some water first. I'm going to get some water, then I'm going to get on gameplay. Then we're going to go back to Poop City, and we're going to do something we haven't done for a little bit. Dinosaur train, peeps! Let's do it! Man, we're back, and we got Toad, and Hardware, and Mobility, and I think Gameplay. Are you still here, Gameplay? Oh, no, we lost Gameplay somewhere along the way. Oh, no way we did! I gotta run back and find Gameplay. So, we'll have to find him. But we got these guys over here right now. And, yeah, I actually tried to put Blue Dolph and, I tried to put the double on top of Mobility, and I just couldn't get it to work. I couldn't get them to stay on. They kept falling off, so I just dropped them off. It didn't matter. It wasn't that big of a deal. But we got these guys over here now. It was quite a little bit of a journey, I got to be honest with you. The Mobility, I think we might change his name. Yeah, I think we need to do that right now, guys. Hold on. Let's go over to Mobility, and we're just going to change his name a little bit, too. Let me see here. Change name, bracket S, bracket. Slow-mo ability. Oh, yeah. Slow-mo. Can we? There we go. Wow. We'll just do it with an SLO. There we go. Slow-mo ability is over here. And so, yeah, that's going to be it for today, guys. I'm going to go find Gameplay. Let me go like this. I'm going to go find Gameplay. I'm sure he'll be fine. But, yeah, I hope you had a fun time hanging out today. We got all the walls done for the base. It's totally amazing. Super secure. Cool spot. We're going to do some great stuff and things over here. But I had a great time hanging out. I hope that you did too. If you guys liked the video, please don't forget to hit the like button and show your support.